in this box is a very interesting graphics card, and it has an equally fascinating origin story. It involves... Well, I'm not going to tell you what it involves, because I think someone else can tell this story a lot better than I can. Mr. Dapz, whose graphics card this actually is. So thank you very much, Dapz, for sending the card over. Dapz would have posted his origin story video. Go check it out, because we're not going to cover it in today's video. What we're going to do with this graphics card is the only thing I know how to do with a graphics card, which is use it unreasonably. You know it's going well when it can barely render the low video memory warning. Now, with all the suspense building out the way, in this box we have an Nvidia GT 1010. Not a 1030, not a 710, a 1010. Which is a graphics card that's existence is very ethereal, and honestly, at this point, I'm still not entirely sure that there isn't just a fart in this box, but we'll open it up and find out soon enough. In here we have... Oh. A box that Mr. Dapz left in here just to dox himself. Very good job, Dapz, well done. And in this, I'm thinking, is the graphics card. Now, apparently our merchandise has been carefully inspected by Apple, which is a bit weird, I don't know. What? Now, as you can tell from the packaging, this graphics card clearly wasn't bought from, like, a micro center. And as far as I understand, the process of getting this graphics card from China was very difficult and involved smuggling inside various UPS delivery people, so I'm really excited to test it out. Feels a bit damp in here. And then in this grocery store bag, we have... Oh, the beauty! Look at that! Physically, as you can tell, the GT 1010 is a Herculean behemoth of a graphics card, and I'm sure the performance will be the same. In terms of rear IO, the GT 1010 is a little different to its bigger brother, the 1030. We have a Mesozoic period port on the back and an HDMI port. Whereas on the back of the 1030, it's all digital with a DVI port, for whatever that's worth. Physically though, aside from the OEM-ness of the 1010, the two cards are very clearly related. And those similarities persist in terms of specs. The 1010 is based on the same GPU as the 1030, just with some shader units disabled. In all fairness, performance-wise, the 1030 can't really afford a lobotomy, but we'll see how they stack up later on. Interestingly, just like its older brother, the 1010 is available in both a GDDR5 version and a runty DDR4 version, a fact that caused me a tiny bit of confusion later on in the video. But with that, let's drop the 1010 in a system and see how it's recovered from its lobotomy. Now, the system I'm using to test the monstrous GT 1010 is this Pink Madness build in the Nezuko-chan case. It's got a fast, modern AMD CPU in it and a bunch of RAM, so we can be 100% sure the test system won't restrain the power of the GT 1010. Oh, I just noticed, it looks like the connector just has, like, 4 PCIe lanes? Interesting. Oh yes, I think the GT 1010 fits in beautifully in this system. Now, I think by far the most reasonable monitor we can use to test the GT 1010 is this behemoth LG 48 4K OLED panel from the previous video. It just seems like a perfect match. But before we try some 4K gaming on the 1010, let's ease it in a little. Now, the GTA 5 running at 1080p low settings, this is not bad. Now, I was not expecting it to be this playable, but I clearly was just underestimating the power of the GT 1010 because look at that, like 1080p GTA 5 is running well. Visually, 1080p low stretched over a massive 4K display doesn't look great, but at least we have some performance left in the tank for native 4K gaming, which we'll get to in a bit. Yeah, my memory of GT 1030 performance is clearly unfair, because this 1010 is running games well. CSGO at 1080p low settings is playable. We don't even have that much input lag. It's pretty good. There's just no other way to say it. The GT 1010 is a voracious beast, churning out a strong 35-ish frames per second at 1080p low. Now, exaggeration aside, it is still running Battlefield 5. I wouldn't want to play online like this, but I think it's pretty impressive.
And after being impressed by a couple frames per second, I tried Cyberpunk, which seems to have been a game too far because it just refused to launch.
I think, at this point, it's a good time to drop in the GT 1030, which is its slightly bigger brother, and see how the two compare before we try some 4K gaming on the 1010. Now we've got the GT 1030 in here, which I'm assuming is gonna be at least, what, 20 better than the 1010? Why is it running at like half the frame rate the 1010 did? That doesn't make any sense. The 1010 has a smaller number in the name. Surely it's slower.
Now the reason this was happening was because I used a DDR4 1030 because I assumed the 1010 used DDR4. So when I messaged Dapz telling him what a gigachad his 1010 was, he was like, yeah, it's because it's a GDDR5 version, you idiot. Which is a bit embarrassing and concerning because I didn't think I had a GDDR5 1030 to compare it to. Or did I?
A few moments later.
So I just dug this naked and confused GDDR5 1030 out of a random bin in my office. I don't know what happened to its cooler. I'm not even sure if it still works at this point. So what I'm gonna do is transplant the cooler from the DDR4 1030 onto it, and then hopefully we have a more reasonable competitor for the 1010. Oh, wow, that just came off. Look at those pathetic DDR4 loser modules. It makes me sick. Anyway, let's try the other card. Oh, look at the tiny little baby GT 1030 die. Oh, that's a very big problem. Despite them both being gigabyte cards, the cooler mounting doesn't line up between the two. It's a little annoying. Although, I actually think I remember what happened to the cooler for the GDDR5 1030. So the reason the card was naked was because I used its heatsink as a CPU cooler. So I ended up splicing a different cable onto the fan of it, which actually means this cooler is not gonna work on the graphics card anymore. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove this fan and replace it with the fan on the DDR4 version. And then we'll have the correct connector and stuff. So let's see if that works. Like that? That's really annoying. The two heatsinks are identical. The only thing they changed was where the mounting holes are. At least the fans are interchangeable, so that helps. Yay, it's finally got its dignity back! But now we need to see if the bin corpse still works. PC's been on a while, the monitor's on, but there's no signal out. It's not promising. No! Yeah, it doesn't work. I think that's why I used its cooler. Yeah, it doesn't work. Oh, it does! It was just jabating me! Oh, thank you! Okay, yes, that makes a whole lot more sense. And basically, what we've learned from today's video is that the DDR4 version of the GT 1030 is complete garbage, clearly. This is running a little bit better than the GT 1010.
And when it comes to CSGO and Battlefield 5, the improvements in performance were slightly less minor, but still not massive. But enough of that, let's do something terrible to the GT 1010.
This is 4K with everything else on low settings, but it's a GT 1010! And it's running fine. Like, it's not the most amazingly playable experience, but like, I don't think GTA 5 ran this well on the PS3. Even CSGO is kind of playable. I mean, I wouldn't want to use this to play competitive CSGO, but you can like shoot bots in the face and it doesn't feel too horrible. Okay, that's a great start.
A few moments later.
That's not a warning I've ever seen from Battlefield 5 before. I guess it's just telling us no. Like, I do not want to do this with your graphics card.
Next up, I tried to launch Forza at 4K, which went very well.
You know it's going well when it can barely render the low video memory warning.
I then spent quite some time struggling to get into the settings so that I could address the warning.
So, up once, press the button. Now we're leaving it. We don't want to spook it and accidentally skip over. There we go. It's happening. Now I think it's fully selected. Settings.
After some more struggling, I identified the problem.
Why is it all on ultra? I don't know why the game thought it needed to preset everything to ultra. That seems a little bit brave.
Eventually though, I got Forza running at 4K on the 1010.
And with the little GT 1010 and everything in low settings, we can actually get about 12 frames per second at 4K. I know that I'm saying that like it's an achievement. We do have a very special tool at our disposal, and that is FSR 2.2, I think it said it was. Let's start with quality. It is now running worse than it was running before. Why did that happen? We lost more than half of our frame rate. I feel like it should be the other way around. Let's try ultra performance. See, again, it makes the game look worse, but also run worse. I don't... It's the worst of both worlds. Hell yeah, that's amazing. Okay. Oh yes, my favorite potato vindicator, Half-Life 2. I would be very surprised if the GT 1010 can't run this well at 4K. Especially considering how good the GTA 5 performance was. It's always impressive how well Half-Life 2 manages to run at very high resolutions on potato systems. And it's no exception with the GT 1010. Hey, even in the like airboat section, we're getting over 100 frames per second, which, you know, this is the hardest bit of Half-Life to render. So that's quite impressive. And this isn't even at low settings. This is 4K mostly high. Although, if you remember, the RX 6400, which is like AMD's newer version of this card, basically, kind of, I guess, that could do this at 8K, which is a much higher resolution. So, yeah, maybe the 1010 isn't that beastly.
But at least it's a decent bit faster than a modern Intel iGPU. For whatever that's worth. And with that, thank you very much, Dapz, for sending over the GT 1010. Don't forget to check out his origin story video. It really is pretty wild. And yeah, until the next video, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.